Hello, welcome back to my Let's Play of Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. Let's just jump back into our game. And where we left off, we just finished our go-kart track. And it's bringing a lot of customers, so I think we're just going to expand it, the line. Which will cause a temporary line malfunction. People will go crazy, won't be able to find their paths again. We're just going to extend it out here for now. Oh, it's a different design. Alright. One thing I forgot to do last time was to put litter bins over here. I mean, there are some over here hidden in the middle, but they won't be really able to find that. And $23 is way overpricing, but we seem to be able to get our customers in to get into the park, so we'll just leave it there at that price. What I'm planning to do now is probably to build a roller coaster right here. It's probably going to be a shuttle launch. Just corkscrew roller coaster. Just like the Cobra. Which way to build it? I think I want to build it here, but I'm going to extend the path first so we can get the general idea of where going to be built. The entrance would be like right there. We'll build a nice little station too. It'll go this way. Yep. Alright. That's long enough for the station. First off, let's test the roller coaster. What? Oh. Fail. Oh, dang it. Oh, huge mistake. You have to set it to reverse incline launch shuttle mode. I did not do that. Hopefully it works now. Yes, it does. I don't see why I let you do a backward lift if it's not set to that. You guys can watch that in this screen. It's a long coaster. Anyways, let's just fix the path. Oh, you walked in. You're gonna get lost now. Peeps in this game, once they get lost, like as in they're not on a path, they'll probably just go in random directions. Random directions, they can get like halfway across the park. You'll never find them again. And look at him. Look at him go. Where's he going? Hey, not that way. Can you not? Hey. Might as well assist him in getting lost. We'll build him a little island over here. I mean, why not? No, that's actually going to be really expensive. Not yet. Yeah, I'll just... I will just forget about him. It's not like something's going to... He can swim, right? He can probably swim. I'm assuming he can swim. Alright. Now that he's taken care of, we can finally finish the path. Our coaster. We'll have the entrance right there, the walk through the door, and we'll check out the test. It's not the best ratings, but incline launch shuttle coasters are really popular in this game. Their lines fill up like immediately once peeps get to it. And when I say immediately, I mean they'll be full. It'll be full once we get like 400 guests. Just like this line's full. There's our first coaster. I think I'm gonna design some scenery for it. I like to go with the design of white for the walls, and then light blue for the windows. I might speed this up, but it probably won't. Senior building tip: if you hover over a object that's already hovering in the air and hold control, it'll like replicate the level or the height of the object, so you can just quickly replicate objects at the same height. So if you're building a roof and you hold control, these will all be at the same height, and here is where it would be under it, so you can like quickly build roofs and stuff like that. I didn't know that till like yesterday, so would have used it, but couldn't. Building. It's off center. Dang it. That's gonna annoy. But what? Wow, failed. Another fail in this series. I can't count three. One, two, three. One, two, three. It's totally not off center. What am I talking about? And there's a nice little coaster. I don't think the line's filling up just yet. Nope. That's because we don't have enough guests yet. Our number's still increasing. We're making money. Last 2 months we've made $1,200, which is good. Guests in parks is rising. It's only been 4 months. Got 314 guests. Dang it. I really should have set a timer. I have no idea what time it is again. I'll probably cut this episode into two parts. I had a nice little outro at the end. And I think I'm going to design the scenery for this ride. Alright, that's pretty nice. We've got that taken care of. We seem to be getting more and more throw up from the Enterprise, I think. We can actually change the settings on this. Let's change that, I think. Just rotation mode. Never mind, we're stuck with lots of puke in this area. Unless we build more. Not build. Hire more handymen. And one thing about scenery, like this station here, anything within four tiles within a ride is counted, within a roller coaster ride, is counted to increase its excitement. So before, the excitement was a little lower than that. I think probably like 2 points lower. That's in 0.02 points lower. But if you have a really big coaster and you have tiny bushes, that can add up to like 2 points, I think, or at 1 point. Probably just one. And we're going to see the complaints of the people. Goat carts one. This means that they're going to tend to leave the line quicker. So we're going to add some TVs. This attracts more people to the line, which is the downside of televisions. But if it's full already, then why not just add them just to keep the people who are already in line waiting for the goat carts in there. And that seems to be our only complaint. We're not too crowded yet because of this big plaza. We're not getting any guests anymore. Pretty much averaged out. If you really need more money, you can change your research, how much money you're spending in research here. No, here. It's a $200 per month thing, so you could be losing lots of money on that. And if you don't really want more rides or scenery, stuff like that, you don't really need it. One thing that we'll do later on to get lots more customers or guests, graphics glitch. That's going to be annoying. Anyway, so one thing that you can do to attract a lot more people is to advertise your park. Once you get more money, if you buy all of these advertisements for the max amount, no matter what thing they are for, like it could be free food for the burger joint, and that'll add up, and it'll make people feel as if your park is cheaper overall. They might not even buy anything from the burger stand, but they will be attracted. They will be more attracted to come to your park than they would otherwise. And it's a nice way to attract customers, but we're not going to really get into that now, because if we did, our park would become way too crowded. So I think we're going to stay away from that. Alright, so I think I'm going to end the recording here. It'll probably be split up into two parts. Thanks for watching. Here's our finished station with the scenery around. We're going to add a little more variety in the trees, such as this one. Give it a nicer feel. And we're just going to end it off here. And next episode, we're dealing with our money crisis. $26. We can't do anything with that. We went on a spending rampage, spent 2,000 grand terraforming, building scenery. We ended up with a really nice station, and now we're in the negatives. So we'll deal with this problem next episode in Let's Play Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. Thanks for watching.